question. What does the term "the right hand possesses" mean? This is mentioned so many times, and we would like to come. We would like clarification of the phrase, please. The right hand possession is what known in English, I think, as concubine, whatever, I don't know. I always forget to memorize this word, and I don't use it. What is it? This is a prisoner of war. In Islam, slaves can only come through wars. So in Islam, if there is a war and we have prisoners of wars, we don't throw them in Guantanamo for 10 or 15 years without any trial. We don't execute them. We take them as slaves. And in Islam, slavery is permissible only through wars. Now, if a man has a woman as his slave, he has the right to have intercourse with her. She's not his wife, and she is bought and sold in the market of slavery. One would say, whoa, this is barbaric. Well, this was found in Christianity and in Judaism. Go and look into your Bibles. But when we say this, you have to look at the holistic picture. Don't say that, whoa, this is barbaric. How can a man sleep with a woman just because he bought her, and then he sells her after a month? And isn't this prostitution? No, it is not. It has nothing relating to prostitution. It is the prisoners of wars. They are slaves, and they are treated as slaves. But look how Islam treats slaves. First of all, you're not allowed to beat them. The Prophet saw one of his companions beating a slave, and he said, oh, so-and-so, remember Allah's powers over you when you do what you're doing. And the man said, this slave is free for the sake of Allah. He set him free. Also, if you look at the Quran, there you would find numerous places in the Quran where Allah Azza wa Jal makes the expiation of a sin that you free a slave. The first expiation, for example, if someone kills someone by mistake, he has to set a slave free. If he's unable, then he has to fast for 2 consecutive months. So I killed him by mistake. I was driving and I ran over him. He died. The Islam tells you have to give the blood money to his family, and also you have to free a slave. If you swear by Allah, I'm not going to go to my brother's house tomorrow, and then you change your mind, the first thing to do is free a slave. If you say to your wife, you are like my mother, I'm not going to have intercourse with you. You're punishing her and punishing yourself. It's not a divorce, but you're simply saying that you are haram for me. You're like my sister. You're like my daughter. Well, Islam tells you if you want to go back to sleep with her, you have to free a slave. First of all, if a person has intercourse with his wife during the daytime of Ramadan while both of them are fasting, free a slave. If this, if that, everything, you look around you, you will find that the first expiation you do is freeing a slave, which means that Islam encourages slaves to be freed, but at the same time, it gives them a chance to live in Muslim houses, to see how Muslims, as in the hadith of Abu Dharr al-Ghafari, may Allah be pleased with him, when one saw him with his slave, and they were both wearing the same clothes. And they said, subhanAllah, how do you clothe your slave in the same clothes that you are wearing? It's the same money, the same cost, the same designer's clothing. He said, well, this is the instruction of the Prophet to feed them from what we eat and to clothe them from what we wear. Now, nobody on earth does this with not his slaves. Nobody does this with their servants. So this shows you that Islam gives honor and dignity even to the slaves. However, if a person buys a slave woman and he sleeps with her and she becomes pregnant, this is for her sake, because the minute she gets pregnant, she cannot be sold and she cannot be inherited and she cannot be given as a gift. Her pregnancy sets her free. So she is now known as the mother of a child. She cannot be sold or dealt with financially. She's not free. She still stays with her master, and master owns her, and he has to be kind for her, but he cannot sell her. And if he dies, immediately she becomes free, and no one can deal with her. And Allah Azza wa Jal knows best.